Snow White and Narcolepsy by Teresa, Annalise, Monica, and Michael.
It was the middle of winter and there was a queen who was expecting a child. One snowy day, she suddenly had terrible stomach pains and had to be seen by a doctor immediately. She had a baby girl, but when the baby was pulled out, she had the umbilical cord wrapped around her neck. The baby girl came out healthy, but the mother unfortunately passed away. Before the queen passed, she named her daughter Snow White. Years later, the king married another woman. The woman was very jealous of Snow White and wanted to kill her because of her beauty. Shortly after their marriage, Snow White began feeling random bursts of drowsiness. There were moments in the day when she would be completely rested and still feel as if she could fall right back to sleep. One day, the queen noticed Snow White reading a book after breakfast when she slowly began falling asleep. The woman thought, "Now is my chance," so she brought in a huntsman to take Snow White away. To his surprise, she never woke from her slumber, even while he was transporting her away. When Snow White woke up, she was in a forest surrounded by all kinds of wilderness. There were many birds chirping, and to her surprise, it seemed as if it were still morning. What Snow White hadn't realized is that it was the next day. When Snow White went to go admire the beauty of nature, her knees suddenly buckled, and her knees felt weak for a few minutes. When she dropped to the ground, she noticed a small pouch full of some bread and wine. The person that had taken her away was thoughtful enough to leave her something behind that would give her a better fighting chance at surviving. After she enjoyed some of the wine and the bread, she suddenly felt drowsiness and couldn't help but fall asleep again. Snow woke up and saw a small house nearby. She let herself in and utilized the home because it was empty. When she grew tired, she let herself into the bedroom. As the sun set, the homeowners arrived. There were 7 homeowners total, and they were dwarves. When they went inside, they discovered someone might be intruding on their home. A chair had been moved, food had been eaten, and wine glasses had been missing. The 7 dwarves quickly checked their room for intruders, and they found Snow White. At first, they were angry, but when they noticed she was only a girl, they let her sleep. When morning came, they inevitably became acquainted. Snow White told them all about her evil stepmother. She mentioned that the huntsman brought her there to spare her life from the new queen. The 7 small homeowners agreed to let her stay if she cleaned, cooked their meals, washed dishes, and kept their beds neat and tidy, which Snow agreed to do. While the little men away are at work, Snow is left home alone. Because of this, the dwarves warned her, "Beware of your stepmother. She will soon know you are here. Let no one in the house." Now the queen believed the huntsman killed Snow on her behalf. She walks up to a mirror and asks, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of us all?" The magic mirror replied to her, "Queen, thou art of beauty rare, but Snow White, living in the glen with the 7 little men, is 1,000 times more fair." This made the queen very angry. The mirror does not lie, so this must mean the huntsman lied to her about the death of Snow White. The queen's envy got the best of her, and she became determined to kill Snow. Coming up with the perfect plan, the queen disguised herself as a peasant wearing ragged clothes and face paint and headed to the glen where the mirror had mentioned Snow White living. She went right up to the door with no hesitation to knock. "Fine wares for sale, fine wares for sale," said the queen in disguise. Snow White peeked through the window and saw that it was only a little old woman, so she let her in. With no hesitation at all, the queen in disguise dressed Snow in the new silk. But with no time to waste, the queen fastened it too tight. Poor Snow lost all of her breath and fell down. Not breathing, the queen assumed her dead and fled as happy as can be. If Snow White is dead, then the queen will be the fairest of them all and have nothing left to envy. Not very much time passed before the dwarves arrived to find poor Snow's lifeless-looking body on the floor. The 7 dwarves were terrified to see her lying there. They quickly picked her up in a panic and felt how tight the silk was upon her. In no time at all, they found something to cut the ribbons of the silk to free her lungs. Then she drew a breath of air and she was alive once more. When Snow White gained enough strength to speak, she told the dwarves what happened. When the dwarves heard what had happened, they said, "The old woman was no other than the wicked queen. You must beware of letting anyone in when we are not here." As soon as the queen got back home, she asked the magic mirror once more, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of us all?" Then the mirror replied once more, "Queen, thou art of beauty rare, but Snow White, living in the glen with the 7 little men, is 1,000 times more fair." When the queen heard that Snow White was still living, she was mortified. The queen knew that Snow fell into slumber all too easy to not take advantage. "I'll make a poison tea that will put her to sleep forever," the queen exclaimed. She dressed as a tea merchant and returned to the dwarf's house. "Tea for sale, tea for sale," said the queen in disguise. "Go away, I can't let anyone in," said Snow. "You can't even open the door?" asked the wicked queen in disguise. Snow pauses for a moment, then thinks, "Well, as long as she does not enter the home, it should be fine, right?" Snow hesitantly opened the door and took the cup of tea. "Drink up, it is apple-flavored." "The sample is on me," said the queen. Snow took a single sip and fell to the floor. "At last," said the queen, and she left. When the dwarfs came home and saw snow on the floor once again, they knew the queen must have just been there, so they looked everywhere for a sign to help her. But there were no ribbons to cut this time. She was dead. Snow was so beautiful they could not bury her. They decided to put her in a glass coffin at the top of the mountain to honor her beauty. The dwarfs said their prayers and left. That very same day, a prince riding his horse nearby caught a glimpse of Snow White in the glass. Her beauty captivated him. He lifted the glass and picked her up to wake her, only she did not wake up. Perhaps she needed to see a doctor. So the prince threw her over his horse, and as soon as her stomach hit the stallion, she threw up the tea, and she lived once more. Confused and startled, Snow asked the prince, "Where am I?" And he replied, "Well, you are with me." Snow White blushed. "Marry me," said the prince. After all, the prince did save her, and he was handsome too. She agreed and left with him to his castle. The evil queen learned of the news and was so overwhelmed with hate and anger that she decided to end her life. Then Snow and the prince lived happily ever after. The end.